All right, so today is a little bit of spring cleaning. I'm out here working on all my tubs, checking on all my animals, and kind of cleaning some things. So I've got to go through, I've got to start pulling leaves, I've got to start rinsing out some water, adding new water. Usually in the winter time, I'm gonna let all that leaf litter accumulate and it's gonna insulate so that the turtles stay warm while they're under. And just kind of in general, checking on things. It's been raining basically nonstop, so today's one of the first days where we're kind of got a brief break, so I'm kind of running around doing everything as fast as I can. So this is going to be a mix of camera footage and phone footage, whatever I have on hand to kind of grab some clips while I'm working. But follow along and I'll show you some of my setups, some of the stuff I'm doing to maintain things, and yeah, that's it. All right, I'm gonna release this little male striped mud turtle right into here. There you go, buddy. Explore this. These guys will be in here temporarily until I get the striped mud turtle pond set up, but they should enjoy it in here. Just did a brief cleaning on the pond. Still has a lot in it. I need to work on the filters and everything, but typical mud turtle, they're real shy to come out. Whoop. We'll just set him. There he goes. He's a biter, so gotta watch out for him. All right, so these are some snails that I culled from my plants, and these are really good for the loggerhead musk turtles and the map turtles in this pond. So I'm just going to deposit these here, and the turtles will end up finding them, and the ones the turtles don't find will end up breeding. This is a hide that I made using a tree that had fallen in the backyard. I peeled the bark off of it and kind of pushed one end of it into the ground, and it makes like a nice little cave. And during the winter, the box turtles stayed inside of those. And days like today, they come out and sit at the edge or they run around. So all of these kind of seemingly unfortunate things, like having a tree fall on my fence, turned into something that was pretty useful to me. And I really like using these kind of half log bark things. All right, so this is a stock tank that I keep my small turtles, like baby turtles, in. They're also in here with some yellow blotched map turtles. And it's just a pretty simple tank. It's not very pretty, but I do have them in here. Right here is just it's a pump inside with a filter, and it's just rerouted and just recirculates the water. There's a little hole right there to relieve some pressure from the pump so that it's just not going too crazy in there. And then there's another pump straight down here that's a pond pump, and it runs all the way up into this filter. And so basically this entire tank is being filtered through two different pumps and two different filters, and it keeps the water, as you can see, water's pretty clear in there. Keeps it nice and clean for these guys, because I do have some soft shells in here, and in the winter, when I put everybody in here, the bio load is pretty high, and you can kind of see that the bio load's high just by the amount of algae. But the water is clean, the water is clear, works pretty well. Let's see, I think you can see there's a soft shell on the bottom right there. And underneath this area right here, you can see it's where the grandis likes to hang out. So yeah, this setup works pretty good. Like I said, it's not the prettiest, but in the winter, it works pretty well for just kind of getting babies through the winter. I don't always like to leave babies out, just in case the temperature swings too much. Babies don't really handle temperature swings very well unless they're buried super deep or overwintering in the nest. And speaking of overwintering in the nest, that's what these little painted turtle babies did, and I moved them into here. So once it stops raining in the next couple days, this whole tank, pumps and everything, is going to be outside, and I'll actually move the yellow blotched maps. They'll go actually move with the peltifer in a different tub, so then this will just be hatchling turtles outside. And I'll reset up after I drain it and everything. I'll kind of do some cleaning and reset it up, and then do a whole video on that. All right, so I've drained this Florida snapping turtle tub, and I'm cleaning off the gravel and the rocks. Just giving it a good spray down. Got the pump and filter out. And then I'm gonna refill it and put these guys back in. But this is just some of the maintenance I have to do every spring. So it's one of my Florida snappers that was in that tub. And just let him get a nice little walk while I work on that. They look so pretty in the flowers. You get a good look at those tubercles that separate the Florida snapping turtle from the common. They're a good looking turtle, very different. Right, so I also brought this guy out to kind of get him cleaned up and get a good look at that injury on his head. It's still a scar, it's still a wound that's healing. It's gonna take time. It was a very major wound, but overall he's doing good. He's been eating. He just started recently eating this week. I have a feeding video posted the other day. So I just wanted to get him out and check on him. He looks good and I'm really happy. From this angle, you can actually see how much damage was done to his head and how much of his head is missing from somebody just being a jerk and shooting him in the head. That whole top corner of his head is just completely gone. And that's actually an area that houses a lot of the jaw muscles that he would use to feed with. So he ends up kind of having to use kind of one side of his mouth when he feeds. But these are incredibly tough animals and he's done really well, considering. Introduced the hybrid snapping turtle to his temporary outdoor setup. I just wanted to make him a very basic tub. It's full of little dragonfly larvae, snails, little ghost shrimp. I'm gonna put some live-bearing fish in here, and it'll give him a place to kind of hang out outside naturally, but also something small where I can easily find him in here if I need to bring him inside or check up on him. So we'll just let him sink into there. And I'm gonna start netting out some live fish from one of my other ponds, and we'll add those, and he should have a fun little habitat in there. He looks pretty good. He did have a touch of fungus while I was out of town, which was really stressful for me. You can actually see it a little bit on his leg right there was a little bit of fungus. But through dry docking and water changes and stuff, he pulled through just fine. But fungus is something that you need to be mindful of. Now, when I keep turtles in these acidic habitats full of leaves, the acidity of the water from the leaves actually prevents fungus from growing. So that's a good thing. But he's kind of giving me the eye. So I'm gonna give him a little bit to get settled. But yeah, this is his habitat. I'm gonna run a bubbler on here to kind of help clean the water and oxygenate it. But a very natural setup. You can actually see there's some little snails and stuff climbing around on this old water hyacinth. And he'll eat those, and they'll be like a nice little snack for him. I'm just really glad that spring is here. I feel like every winter, I feel like it takes forever, and I feel like spring's never gonna come. And it, I don't wanna say it gives me like anxiety, but it always just feels like, get here, get here, get here, and you're just waiting on spring. And then when it finally hits, you have so much to do that you're just running around, and it's hard to like stay pointed in one direction. Yeah, so the other day, while I was cleaning the pond, this crayfish was kind of high and dry because I had to drain the pond, so I need to put him back in, send him back home. So we're gonna put him in this little shallow water area. Here you go, buddy. That's the weirdest defensive pose I've ever seen.
So, he'll figure it out. They always do.
All right, so right now I'm making a temporary setup for a blind alligator snapping turtle. This one was a rescue. There's actually an old video about it. I'll post a link in the description. But yeah, so while I'm working on the alligator snapping turtle pond, I gotta make a temporary stock tank tub for her to hang out in until it's done. So right now I'm moving that tub from the garage into outdoors now that the weather's good. But what I wanna do is everything, even if it's in a stock tank, everything deserves some kind of stimulation. Even if she's blind, she deserves, some kind of stimulation to let her feel like she's in the wild, or let her feel like, you know, there's something going on. I don't like doing bear tanks. I think bear tanks really just cheat them out of getting to be what they are. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut some of this bamboo. We're going to put some bamboo in there and kind of give her some, you know, some sensory, you know, feeling and some stuff to kind of, you know, smell and interact with. I'm also going to put some rocks and logs in there, and that should help her, you know, feel a little bit more comfortable as opposed to being just dropped into a bear stock tank. All right, we've got our bamboo, and I'm gonna bring this back up and set it in the tank. Ooh, bamboo is so cool. Just gonna kind of turn it any which way as it fills with water, and as she moves around in here, she'll feel like she has some cover. And again, since she's blind, that feeling of cover is really gonna matter. So what this is a 110-gallon Tough Stuff tub. I really like these tubs. There's a Florida snapping turtle tub right next to it. So again, this is just a temporary setup. All right, so I do wanna talk a little bit about this turtle and why I have this turtle. I'm actually licensed by the state of Georgia to use this turtle for education. And she's actually been really, really good. She's come to some schools with me. She's been a part of the Flint Riverkeeper meetings, finding the Flint, and just been a really good ambassador for her species. Being blind, she was in a situation where she was in a place where people wanted to eat her, wasn't able to hide because she didn't know she wasn't hidden, and just in a bad situation. I got licensed by the state of Georgia to use her for education, and all of my alligator snapping turtles come with me when I do educational talks. So just wanted to kind of touch on that. And alligator snapping turtles are protected in the state of Georgia, so you can't handle one or have one without some kind of a permit. So that is something to be aware of, and they are protected throughout their entire range. All right, so she's in there, and she's gonna kind of dig underneath those plants. Kind of gives her the same feeling she would have in the wild. She would be digging underneath plants and plant material to get underneath things where they feel comfortable. She can feel all that on her skin, so she might not be able to see that she's hidden, but she's at least gonna feel like she's hidden. So, like I said, temporary setup, but this will keep her happy. And she's gonna start eating soon, which is great. All right, well, thanks for watching this video. I appreciate all you guys and all your views. Welcome to all the new subscribers. It's awesome to kind of see some new people kind of coming in addition to everybody that's been following me this entire time. So I hope you enjoy the channel. I hope you're learning things, and I learned from you guys in the comments as well. So thank you. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. I upload videos every week, and always trying to upload and add more content all the time. So please subscribe if you're not already. And thanks again for watching.